YouTube, what's up? It's Magnus. Today we are doing a deep cycle marine battery install in the bed of Scourge. And I'm going to show you, well, one of the reasons is for this, and the other reason is for that right there. 2000 watt Jupiter modified sine wave power inverter. We tried hooking it to the main battery. It's really not recommended. I just did it to see if it would work, my power tools, and it would work, but it's not the best setup when you're going to be using a power inverter. A deep cycle battery is recommended. You see, this is how we had everything ran. You remember these wires are for the winch, and these other wires that you see, this other ground, that is for the inverter that we have running from inside the cab up under through here. Now, in order to set up to work properly, we have to get a smart battery isolator. And this is a true smart battery isolator, great company, dealt with them in the past. And this 12 volt, 140 amp model is exactly what we need for this install. And we're gonna mount this in between our starting battery and the marine battery. And it will monitor, cut on and cut off as needed. And it's gonna actually be handling the charging of this battery from the main power system of the truck's alternator and battery. And we're gonna ground it to the other battery. So when I use my quick disconnect in the truck, it'll disconnect this battery also when the truck's gonna be sitting for an extended period of time. Okay, we got more two gauge wire that's gonna be going to the inverter. Now, as far as the winch goes, we're just gonna take the wires we have existing now running from the front to the back. We're gonna cut those in half, and then we're gonna attach them to the marine deep cycle battery with battery terminals. All right, this is the battery box we're gonna have mounted inside the bed. We're gonna secure it to the side of the bed liner and actually secure it to the bottom of the bed liner so it'll be sturdy and won't move. We're going to put holes in the lid on this side so we can come through the bed, and we'll have the wires running through, coming through the bed into the box to go to the battery. All right, we got our isolator open up, and this is how you wire this thing up. It's self-explanatory. Okay, you hook your main battery to this first post here that I got the washer on, and then your second battery, that's where you run those wires to wherever second battery you have it, wherever you've got it placed at. And like I said, this thing will run, and it'll monitor the batteries, it'll see what needs charging, it'll shut itself off. And it's got a small ground that I'll hook up here somewhere. But that's pretty much it as far as, you know, wiring this up. Comes with all your hardware. You got your bottom plate there. Then comes with your four screws to mount it. So we got to find a place to mount it up here out the way. And we'll get to hooking this thing up. Okay, we got an isolator wired. Got our main battery cable here. Secondary battery gonna be going to the bed. Then we gotta find a place for our ground. I put dielectric grease on the terminals, and we're gonna close it up and mount it. Okay, isolator's hooked up, so we're pretty much done under the hood. So now we gotta go down here, move some wires around through the body, and start pulling stuff back toward the bed so we can get our battery position and hose drill so we can go ahead and hook up power back there. Okay, we're in the bed of the truck. This is where the battery is going to be positioned, right by the wheel hump. And now we're going to go underneath and we got to pull back the bed liner so we can get access to the holes in the bed so we can pull our wires through and come up. Gonna try to come right in here with the wires and so we can have access to the terminals against the bed, flush on this side. Okay, this is what I was talking about, coming through the bed liner. Got the grommets in. Got grommets on the inside of the bed also. We're in the process of running the wire down. I'm gonna show you another side how it looks. Down through the fender well like that. Okay guys, here's what we did. This is the end result from running the wires through the side of the bed liner, through the inner structure of the bed. We've got the power coming from the main battery. That's the ground from the main battery. And power from the main battery. The isolator is in between the two batteries. Like I said, that's gonna be monitoring and handling the charging of this battery. The two terminals, that's the power inverter that I showed you inside the cab. And we still gotta hook the winch up to it. I got more cable on the way. And we're gonna attach the winch to these terminals right here when they come, when I get that cable. We've got the impact hooked up. We're going to test it out and see what happens, see how much juice we're gonna be pulling. Okay, guys, if you remember when I did the lift videos on Scourge, this was the 1,000 foot-pound Bauer corded impact. This thing requires a lot of juice. So we got it hooked up to our inverter cord right there, and let's okay, we got the 6 gallon 5 feet horsepower part stop back hooked up, working fine, pretty good. Here's Chicago Electric sawzall. All right guys, that's all I got for you today. The whole purpose of these videos is just to give you ideas and show you different ways that you can take a pickup truck and make it more versatile, usable, and give it more function. Installing secondary batteries, installing power outlets so you can run power tools. You saw a lot of examples of tools that you can run with that 2000 watt power inverter. Also, you know, we've got the winch hooked up to the secondary battery to help relieve the stress of the main starting battery that runs the truck, its power system. But yeah, that's all we're doing. And you know, like I said, you know, we're going to be doing some off recovery stuff. But yeah, that's all I got for you today, guys. You know, it's hard to make good use of your truck if you're riding around town with half of a lift kit like these kids are doing these days.
It's been hard.
Okay, so what exactly does that mean, would you say?
That means just plain. Okay. It looks good. That's what it hard means. It looks good. Got the blue paint
clean.
Job.
Yeah, nice. Got that I think it's factory, but...
Don't get me started on that. That's another video for another time. I've been Magnus. I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your weekend. Peace. I'll catch you in the next one. Psychopath, I'm a killer. 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 Psychopath, I'm a killer.